It's a key demonstration of our policy intention to invest in inner city cricket. Inner city cricket is really important if we're going to drive participation. We have to see facilities that will encourage children to play cricket and then move to be able to play outside on grass, but playing here initially, learning the basics of the game, improving their techniques with the kind of assistance they're getting from good coaching. They can sit there. This facility is outstanding. It's as good as the indoor school at Lord's. And it's equally important that we are clearly engaging with our South Asian community. They're interested in cricket already. The parents and the grandparents are keen on cricket. The children are therefore far more likely to be playing. And we really want them to engage within our community. So the ECB is not seeking to tell them what to do. We're seeking to facilitate that they can do whatever it is they want to do. And that means these types of really outstanding schools, and it's a hell of an educational facility. It looks spectacular. The teaching facility itself looks superb from the number of schools I've had the privilege of going to, which are new, modern, light, clear, airy places, you know, with a firm expectation of removing bullying and encouraging people to participate in learning. And in our case, from cricket's point of view of what it can do to help the objectives of the nation in reducing child obesity. And that means playing sport when sport is not a burden, when it's not something you don't want to do, but something you actually enjoy doing, so that you're actually taking exercise without really realising you are. And I think that's a very major part of what we bring.
It's wonderful to see it up and running. It has been a long time in the making. We first started the project in 2008, and it's now 2014, October. But to see the school full and to see people playing cricket within the school and using our investment is fantastic.
Yeah, unbelievable. I think they've got seven lanes. And now that I think Leicester Youth Academy train here, it just shows what good facilities it is. I mean, I certainly didn't when I was growing up playing these facilities, so it's unbelievable. And you see the spirit of the young guys playing and the young girls. It's unbelievable, the energy, it's outstanding.
And the facilities are wonderful. I mean, the lighting, the height of the ceiling, the attention to detail, you know, the soundproofing. I mean, I teach PE here, and along with a number of PE teachers, and in terms of a learning environment, it's a perfect learning environment. Got more space, you know. We can do a lot more observation. We've got observation galleries and so on. So, you know, it's revolutionised the way we deliver PE in particular. But the community side is just huge, I mean, in terms of what we offer. We run it, again, it's given us afforded us the opportunity to run it commercially as well. So we're open 7 days a week. I mean, we are an educational establishment, but we are trying to make some sort of income from it.
It was a very important project because it was the first. It is the first of its type, working with BSF, Building Schools for Future programme, in such a big project. You know, you're talking about a £21 million investment, and we've invested about £1 million in it. So yes, it is very important, and all inner cities are important to us, and Leicester is one such. So we're delighted we've been able to invest here, and that. We're absolutely certain that this is going to be beneficial to the children of Leicester.
Our sport is nothing if we are not part of the community. And in the same way that the historical image of cricket is cricket on the village green, well, actually cricket needs to be played in the centre of the city, in the, you know, in the industrial parts, in the modern housing estates. We need to be able to provide cricket facilities to them. Now, where there isn't grass, it must be indoors. But that's fine, as long as they can play, as long as we can set up competitions for them, then they are the supporters and the spectators of the future. And hopefully, if not our international players, they'll be the parents of our next international players.
There's a massive Asian community here and a real keen interest for cricket. And where better to have it than, you know, I don't know how many lanes it is, but a 6-lane pull-out over there for people to come and enjoy cricket through the winter as well as the summer and have somewhere to practice on a regular basis. It's brilliant for, you know, the rest of the clubs and the community. It's probably one of the best facilities I've seen, to be fair. I've been to a fair few places like this, but this is, you know, it's incredible. You've got a two-sided court, and you can have, generally when I go to indoor facilities like this at schools, you only ever get to have one spot at a time on. And then maybe share half the court. But with here, there's two sides to it. You can have four different lessons at once, and it's just brilliant.
I'm very proud of the fact that this is going to influence so many thousands of children's lives over the next generations. And I think cricket and ECB should be immensely proud of that investment.